Miss Roxy Hart would like to sing a song of love and devotion dedicated to her dear husband, Amos.
$5,000!
It's my hour of need, for Christ's sakes!
Well, I'll get
get it to you, Roxy. I'll get it.
That I borrowed down at the garage, and $700 from the building and loan fund.
That's $2,000.
And that's all I've got so far.
What about her father?
I phoned him yesterday and he told me he could probably raise some money later.
You're a damn liar. I spoke to her father myself, and you know what he told me? He told me that his daughter went to hell 10 years ago and that she could stay there forever before he'd spend a cent to get her out.
I'll pay you $20 a week on my salary. I'll give you notes with interest on a double, triple, so every cent is paid.
That's sweet, but I got a motto in life, and that motto is play square, dead square. Now, when you came to me yesterday, I didn't ask you if she was guilty. I didn't ask you if she was innocent. I didn't ask if she was a drunk or a dope fiend. No stupid questions like that. All I said was, do you have $5,000? And you said yes. But now you haven't got $5,000, so I figure you are a dirty liar.
I'm sorry, Mr. Flynn.
However, I took her case, and I'll keep it because I play square. Now, look, Hart, I don't like to toot my own horn. But believe me, if Jesus Christ himself lived in Chicago today, if he had $5,000, things would have turned out differently. Now here's what we're doing. Tomorrow morning I'll have her name on every front page as the hottest little jazz slayer since Thelma Kelly. Next, we announce we're going to hold an auction to raise money for her defense. They'll buy anything she ever touched. Shoes, dresses, underwear. Plus, we tell them that if by due process of law she gets hanged, the stuff triples in value. I'll give you 20% of everything we make over $5,000. Now that's what I call playing square.
I don't know, Mr. Flynn.
You see, it's like this. Either I get the entire $5,000. Or you'll rot in jail before I bring you to trial.
Listen, Mr. Flynn, I've never been very good at this sort of thing. But couldn't we make some sort of arrangement between us? I am just so flattered that y'all came to see little old me.
Now I bet you want to know why I shot the bastard.
Sit down, dummy.
Mr. Billy Flynn sings the press conference rag. Knows how his mouth never moves. Almost.
Where's your call from?
Mississippi.
And your parents?
Mary Welby.
Where are they now?
6 feet under.
She was granted one more star.
The convent of the sacred heart.
When'd you get here?
1920.
How old were you?
Don't remember.
Then what happened?
I met Amos, and he stole my heart away. Convinced me to elope one day.
Oh, that's terrible. How do I ever go? It's too terrible. You poor, poor dear.
Fred Haisley.
My ex-boyfriend.
Why'd you shoot him?
I was leaving.
Was he angry?
Like a madman. Still, I said, Fred, move along. She knew that she was doing wrong.
Then describe it.
And he came toward me.
With a pistol.
From my bureau.
Did you fight him?
Like a tiger. He had strength and she had none. And yet we both reached for the gun. Oh, yes, oh, yes, oh, yes, we both, oh, yes, we both, oh, yes, we both.
Understandable, understandable. Yes, it's perfectly understandable. Comprehensible, comprehensible. Not a bit reprehensible. It's so defensible.
Sing it,
Roxy.
Who says that murder?
He moved. If someone stood up in a crowd and raised his voice up way out loud, and waved his arm and shook his leg, you'd notice him. If someone in the movie show yelled fire in the second row, this whole place here is a powder keg, you'd notice him. And even without clucking like a hen, everyone gets noticed now and then. Unless, of course, that person it should be invisible, inconsequential me. Cellophane, Mr. Cellophane, should have been my name. Mr. Cellophane, cause you can look right through me, walk right by me, and never know I'm there. I tell ya, cellophane, Mr. Cellophane, should have been my name. Mr. Cellophane, cause you can look right through me, walk right by me, and never know I'm there.
Oh, Andy, I didn't see you there.
Amos, my name's Amos.
Who said it wasn't? It's the kid's name I'm thinking about.
Kid? What kid?
Roxy's kid. You know what she's due? Early fall. That means you couldn't possibly be the father. But I want you to forget all of that. I want you to pass out those cigars anyway. I don't want you to give a damn when people laugh.
Laugh? Why would they laugh?
Because they can count. Can you? Early fall, Roxy's first statement says you two hadn't done no copulating for 4 months prior to the incident.
That's right. We've done no copulating for 4 months. Early fall. Now, wait a minute.
But I want you to forget all that. My client needs your support.
That don't figure out right. I couldn't possibly be the father.
Divorce her? My God, man, you wouldn't divorce her over a little thing like that now, would you?
You're damn right. That's what I'll do. I'll divorce her. She probably won't even notice.
Uh-huh. Are you still here, Andy? I thought you'd gone.
Yeah. I'm still here. I think.
Suppose you was a little cat residing in a person's flat that fed you fish and scratched your ear. You notice him. Suppose you was a woman wed and sleeping in a double bed beside one man for 7 years. You notice him. A human being's made of more than air. With all that bulk, you're bound to see him there. Unless that human being next to you is unimpressive, undistinguished, you know who. Should have been my name, Mr. Cellophane, cause you can look right through me, walk right by me, and never know I'm there. I tell ya, cellophane, Mr. Cellophane, should have been my name, Mr.
Roxy Carter. I shot him because he was walking out on me with a lapse. Signed, Roxy Carter. Do you recognize that signature?
Yes, sir. It's the signature of the lady that used to be my wife.
Exactly. Take the witness.
Hello, Amos.
Amos, that's right, Mr. Flynn. Amos.
Amos, you are at present obtaining a divorce from the defendant. Any reason?
I'll say, the newspaper said that she was expecting a little stranger.
Oh, well, that's hardly grounds for divorce, isn't it?
A little too much of a stranger.
By that you mean you doubted the paternity of the child.
Well, sure.
Did you even bother to ask her if you were the father?
No, sir, but you did.
Just jumped to a conclusion. Do you call that playing square? If Roxy Hart swore that you were the father of her child, which she does!
She does?
I do!
She does! Aww. Step down, Daddy. The defense calls Roxy Hart.
Roxy in the garage, Amos!
Sure!
Oh, Amos, I want a real home.
Fat chance!
So, you drifted into this illicit relationship with Casey because you were unhappy at home.
Most unhappy.
I love you, honey. I love you.
Yet, you do respect the sacredness of the marriage vow.
Gentlemen, to open up the doors. There ain't no ladies now, there's only pigs and whores. And even kids will knock you down. They can pass.